India's 39% of population represents children. Their rights are undeniably imperative for the democracy.
There are a lot of key issues which actually concern or affect the children intensely. According to UNICEF, in India, 20% of the children are suffering from the acute undernutrition. The contemporary state of the children in India is alarming.
According to UNICEF, in India, 20% of children under 5 years of age suffer from wasting due to acute undernutrition. More than one-third of world's children who are wasted live in India. 43% of Indian children under 5 years
are underweight, and 48%, 61 million children, are stunted due to chronic undernutrition. India accounts for more than 3 out of every 10 stunted children in the world. My name is Garvit Bhurani, and today I am at Twitter India office for focusing on the saving the children in India ahead of 2019 Lok Sabha elections. It comprises of the politicians, Indian national spokesperson Priyanka Chaturvedi, Anmol Panwar from Aam Party, and Charu Pragya from BJP. The most basic need for every children is education. Every political party mentions in their manifesto about education, but the detailing is ambiguous. We are joined by the Indian National Congress spokesperson Priyanka Chaturvedi, ma'am.
My first question to you: how do you see the prevailing conditions at the government schools in India?
I think there's a lot that needs to be done. While we have spaces, we haven't been able to utilize those spaces effectively for our children, because of which we've encouraged a whole lot of private schools to flourish, and flourish with fees which are absolutely unaffordable, not just to the poor, but even the middle classes. So I think it's important that the government's focus on capacity building, whether it's with regards to the teachers, whether it's with regards to the welfare of the students, ensuring that they get good quality education at affordable prices.
Don't you think the system recovery calls for a new policy perspective and strategy in the education system?
Policy should always be a work in motion. If a policy is not working the way it should, then it should always be overhauled or worked towards. You know, you can always make it work better for the system. Unfortunately, while we make these policies, we do not see how they are turning out to be on ground. And that is where we are missing out. And that's one loophole which we really need to work on.
Ma'am, air pollution being one of the most imperative issue, a lot of children getting affected due to it. Has the Indian Congress Party been at loggerheads
regarding this?
No, I think every political party realizes the challenge we face. 10 of the most polluted cities in the world are in India. And this is something which should be a cause of worry and should be the main talking point for this nation. Unfortunately, we are so busy talking about issues that do not affect our daily life, that we miss out on the things that really impact our livelihood, impact our life, impact our health, etc. So I think the focus really needs to be brought back to issues that matter to our daily lives.
Ma'am, if you come to power, children in the rural areas are now getting victimized of the gender discrimination. What would the Indian Congress Party do if the party comes in power?
Gender discrimination is not just an issue in rural areas. It is a cross-spectrum issue that we face. And this is something which we all collectively need to build. The Congress Party understands this challenge. It's a societal mindset also which needs to be overhauled. So we're looking at working with civil society, engaging with groups and NGOs which are working in these areas, and come up with a system where we are able to live up to the expectations of our people who were the architects of our constitution, where equal opportunities and equal rights were given despite whatever gender you might have. So it's time to remember the values that we inculcated through our constitution and work on our constitution.
Which issue comes first to your mind when we talk about saving the children in India, and why?
There's so many of them. One issue which is closest to my heart is the children on the streets. How they are used, a lot of them are kidnapped, and then they are put into the trade of begging. My heart really pains when I see children on the street with no basic amenities, the state that they are forced to live in. And these are kids who could have shaped the future of this nation. But they are out begging on the streets or doing, you know, jobs which, as per law, they're not supposed to be doing. There are strict laws which are not being implemented, laws about that these children should not be working at all. But they are forced to do that, and nothing is being done about that. Instead, these children should be provided education and made into people who are contributing to the economy. So that's the top of my mind.
What are your expectations from the elections?
Another sham. You know, whichever party comes to power, it is just about power. Not expecting anything to change, just hoping things don't get worse, and not expecting much, to be honest.
Despite the prohibition, children have been the victims of the wickedness prevailing in the country. It is child marriage and child labor. Girls are not capable of bearing children and many die during childbirth. Children working as a labor neither get to study in schools nor play in parks. We are joined by Charu, Pragya from the BJP party. Ma'am, how do you see the condition of government schools in India?
So our government is working to improve them, because I understand the condition of the government schools has not been so great, but our government has worked really hard on making gender-specific toilets. You want me to look in the camera? Okay. So gender-specific toilets is one thing that we have worked on. 4.5 lakh toilets have been constructed in just 1 year, from 2014 to 2015. Apart from that, we are looking at the maintenance and upkeep of these toilets. We are looking at clean water and sanitation to be provided to these schools. And we are also, of course, looking to upgrade the Right to Education Act.
Don't you think the system recovery calls for for a new policy as well as perspective and strategy in education system?
I think we have a brilliant, very, very good Right to Education policy in a broad perspective, but there are certain things I believe we need to add. One is a deterrent, so that parents who don't send their children to school have something to fear, maybe some sort of a fine or a punishment. It needs to be put in. A deterrent is very essential on an act which is so important for our future. The other thing which is on the agenda of Bharatiya Janata Party is to include pre-primary education and education up to 12th standard, not till 10th, but till 12th standard, and skill-based education in this act.
Air pollution being one of the most imperative issue, a lot of children getting affected due to it. Has the central government been at loggerheads?
There has been some issues, because there has been a green cess which is being collected in Delhi. More than 9,000 crore of that is lying unused, which is a massive amount. It can do a lot of good work for the people of Delhi, for the children of Delhi. And I think we need to start focusing on that. I believe that people who are collecting funds, Delhi government, they need to start utilizing funds.
Slums children who are with weak financial status require the reservation in colleges, but it's irony. Non-deserving student gets the reservation in the colleges. How does the central government see this issue?
So reservation system by our party is being changed. If you look at the latest inclusion which has been done, that is the 10% reservation based on your economic standards, I think that's a brilliant inclusion, and that comes in without taking away reservation from anyone who had it previously. So now people who are genuinely poor will have a chance to avail facilities of reservation. They will have access to good colleges. They will have access to better jobs.
My last question to you, what has the central government done for the in the rural areas for the people who get victimized of the gender discrimination while sending their daughters to their schools, especially in rural areas?
So the entire Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Abhiyan is focused on rural India. It is not focused in cities like Delhi and Mumbai and Bangalore, where girls are very empowered as it is. So the entire mission, which was started by Narendra Modi ji, was focused on rural India. It is focused on educating the girl child. It is focused on eradicating female infanticide, absolutely. And it encourages young girls to go out of their homes, study well, and be on their own feet.
A lot of time, the midday meal schemes in schools across states in India have caused the illness to the children. They do not ensure the cleanliness and hygiene for the children. So we are joined by Anmol Panwar from the Aam Aadmi Party. So my first question to you is, how do you see the prevailing condition at the government schools in India?
The government schools in India, basically, they are in shambles. I mean, if we speak about other states other than Delhi, the situation is really very pathetic, which has been for there since the beginning, for several decades. But the kind of work the Delhi government has done in the field of education, that is appreciated even by the opponents today. We have made systematic and sustained efforts to ensure that we improve the infrastructure, we improve the quality of learning.
Don't you think the system recovery calls for a new policy perspective and strategy in education system?
There's always need for better policies in the government, but we also need to ensure that they also get implemented over the period of time. It's not just that we'll frame policies after policies, and if they don't get implemented, then it's of no use. And this is what has been happening in the past. So this is for the first time that the Delhi government has ensured that they draft a policy in consultation with the parents, with the students, with the other participants in the society, and then also they have ensured that it gets implemented in a proper way.
Sir, air pollution being one of the most imperative issues, a lot of children getting affected due to it. Don't you think the political parties have been at loggerheads?
See, the Aam Aadmi Party and the Delhi government, they have time and again raised this issue that we need to work collectively and ensure that this pollution issue, which is, I mean, one of the prime issues at this point of time in Delhi, because in winters, the pollution levels rise to a very high extent. But we didn't get any support from other political parties, the opponents as well. They always tried to create hurdles because this division of power in Delhi, which has been time and again brought to the fore. So in this election, we are demanding for full statehood so that we have all the powers to implement certain policies in regard to the air pollution, and we can ensure that over the period of time, it gets reduced.
If we talk about the rural areas, a lot of children get victimized of the gender discrimination while sending their daughter through schools. How do you see this, sir?
See, we are working on the sensitization program. Our education policy basically focuses on a holistic development of the children's. Overall personality development is our focus. That's why we have introduced happiness curriculums, and similar programs have been introduced, and they'll be introduced in the future also, which ensure that we make a better human being. We don't just need better academicians, we need better human beings. This is our prime focus.
My last question to you is that slums children with weak financial status get the requires reservation in college. But it's irony, non-deserving student gets the reservation. How do you see this, and what's your take on this?
We are working on every level. For students from 3 to 6 years of age, we have introduced early childcare program, under which the Ambedkar University, which is under the Delhi government, they have introduced 10 pilot schools, which are opened in slums and unauthorized colonies. The space has been allocated with the help of DUSIB, Delhi Shelter Urban Board. And the prime motive was to provide them better education in the initial years so that afterwards they don't need to face any problem.
According to World Health Organization, the 10% of the world population is under 5 years old. But those kids bear the 40% of the burden of the environmentally related diseases. The immense threat has been posed by air pollution for the children, that is playing a malicious role while the political parties have been wrangling.